This is The Issue, and I am the Ghetto Man. Today's issue, the Blue Pill People. I'm a Vietnam vet. I served one tour. Spent a year fighting the communist hordes of the East. I don't like to talk about it very much. In fact, I very rarely bring it up. And after today, I probably won't bring it up again. The Vietnam War was an illegal war. And I was a pawn. And because it was an illegal war, I finally came to grip that I am a war criminal. I had no right to be in that country. There was no declaration of war, and everything I did over there was illegal. And once I was able to understand that, I took all the medals that I had, and I threw them in the trash because they don't mean anything to me. I was a pawn. And I think that's why I never became an alcoholic or was hooked on drugs, is because I looked myself eyeball in the mirror and I said, you were used, what you did was illegal, and I made friends with that. I'll never feel that what I did had any effect on anything positive, at least in our country. Now, when I got back, I swore that I would never pick up a gun again in war. I mean, I'll use one to defend myself if I have to. But in war, I will never pick up another gun unless it was to defend the Republic. Now, I'm not going to mention anything more about my time in Vietnam, and I want you guys to know how I feel. Whether you agree with me or not, I don't care. But that's what I had to do to finally make friends with what I was forced to do in Vietnam. Now, I have a message for you communist snowflakes assholes. You don't have a clue what you are about to walk into. You are nothing but a bunch of anti-American radical Marxists, progressive socialist fascists, racist eugenicist bigots. And I'm telling you right now, you're about to stick your arm down a badger hole. When I got home from Vietnam, I started studying American history, the Constitution, and I also studied communism. When I came home, I found out that everything that I was fighting against was in full force and effect right here in the good old US of A. When I attempted to point out what I felt was the obvious, no one was interested, or they called me a kook. Now, there was a book that I read after I got home that changed my life. It was written by a guy by the name of Gary Allen. It was called None Dare Call a Conspiracy. Little paperback book. I think it went for a buck. Might even been 50 cents, but it was very cheap. You didn't have to spend a whole lot of money. A little bit of paperback, pretty thick. A lot of really good information. Gary Allen talked about the bankers, the Rothschilds, the Morgans, the Federal Reserve, and all the international banking cartels, and how they were running all the countries through the monetary system. I think with Rothschild that said that, give me control over a nation's money and I care not who makes the laws. Now, I got to meet Gary Allen one time before he passed away. He had diabetes so bad, I think they had to amputate his legs. He actually had a rough go of it. But that little book, and I know a lot of people that read it, it changed their lives, changed my life. I learned that in order to understand an issue or to complete a task, that you must approach it with reason, logic, and common sense. I talked to a lot of people. Nobody seemed interested. And I couldn't understand why people were not interested in the truth. After talking to a lot of people, I finally understood why. One word: fear. The whole system was based upon spreading fear to the masses. I was once told that the masses are asses. I'll let you be the judge. Everything that we see, hear, eat, and touch is based on a lie, designed to fill all of our senses with fear. Every TV ad is designed to instill fear. If you had the chicken pox, then you're going to get shingles. Fear. Get the vaccination. Fear. All the commercials are done in slow motion, showing you all these happy people having a great time, distracting your attention while the announcer tells you about a flotilla of side effects, which, by the way, are not side effects at all. They are the effects. From enlarged prostates to life insurance, fear. Lawyers soliciting people over drugs that have harmed them, fear. Health products: if you don't take the supplement, you won't be healthy, fear. Why is this done to us? They promote fear for one reason only, and that's to keep us off balance. Everything is designed to keep the corporate fascist whores in Fat City, squeezing every dime they can out of all of us while keeping us in a constant state of fear. Corporations write the laws. Corporate political whores in Congress pass corporate-created laws. Once passed, the government shoves another unconstitutional law down our throat, forcing the will of the corporations on every citizen in this country. It's the law. Hear everybody say, it's the law. More fear. More fear. The corporate-controlled lamestream media, with its prostitutes, shove fake news down our throats every day, force-feeding the American people a crock of bullshit filled with fear and warmongering. Korea's going to attack us. Russia's going to attack us. China, they're going to attack us too. Fear, 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 and more fear. They play us all like a harp from hell. Then there are the polls. What a joke. Do you agree with the president, or do you disagree with the president bombing Syria or Afghanistan? None of the polls give you a choice as to whether or not the bombings are even legal. Some say the president doesn't have to tell us what he's doing. Are you kidding me? He works for us. He better tell us what he's doing. What about the president anyway? Is he obeying the law? How come no one's talking about that? You know, the biggest lie there is the lie of omission. They keep the most important information from us. Was the president's action legal? That question was omitted. Why is this done? It's done to control the narrative. It's done to control your opinion. It's done to control you. Excuse me. Now, I read the comments on YouTube surrounding Syria and Afghanistan. Most of them, if not all of them, are nothing more than mindless gibberish. Every comment is left does this, right does that. I think the president is doing the right thing. I think the president is doing the wrong thing. It's the Jews this, it's the conservatives that, it's the libtards are assholes, Trump supporters are fascists. Nowhere do you see anybody saying, how about obeying the law? How about obeying the Constitution? All there is, one comment after another, nothing but mindless rhetoric. Nobody has a clue as to what is really going on. Nobody seems to care. Nothing but parrots. Polly want a repeat canned corporate narrative? A narrative that is repeated on every corporate-controlled media channel that you turn to. When the 6 o'clock news comes on, you can click through every channel. And it's the same thing on every one of them. Our airports have become prison training facilities where you are unconstitutionally forced to undergo extensive searches of your person and effects without probable cause or a Fourth Amendment warrant. So intrusive are the searches that if done anywhere else, they would constitute molestation or rape. They force you to witness against yourself without counsel present, as mandated by the Fourth Amendment, and in violation of your Fifth Amendment rights to remain silent. Excuse me. Yeah. They say this is done to protect us from terrorism, all while our borders are wide open. How does government get away with doing this? Well, nobody understands they're constitutionally protected inalienable rights anymore. And if they do, they are afraid to exercise them. Fear takes over. If I don't do what they say, I might get arrested. What a bunch of cowards. The privilege against self-incrimination is neither accorded to the passive resistant nor to the person who is ignorant of his rights, nor to one indifferent thereto. It is a fighting clause. Its benefits can be retained only by sustained combat. It cannot be claimed by an attorney or a solicitor. It is valid only when insisted upon a belligerent claimant in person. McAllister versus Henkel, 201 U.S., page 90. Personally, and I know this is going to probably piss a lot of you off, and you know what? I don't care. I think most Americans have a yellow streak running from the top of their necks right up their assholes. We have been domesticated. We're sheeple. We have become government property. We are slaves. The government owns you. Well, how did this happen? Fear. Fear is the mind killer. How do you give an evil government power? You give it power through fear. Evil only has the power that you give it. Ignorance. Ignorance leads to fear. Fear leads to panic, and panic will kill you. Once you succumb to fear, you're dead. Now, you know, I'm going to share a little personal thing with you. For reasons I really don't want to discuss, but I developed at a very young age aquaphobia, the fear of water. I mean, it was so bad that if I were to fall into the water next to a dock or something, I thought little hungries were going to run out and grab me and pull me under, and that would be the end of me. That really bothered me. What I had to do is I had to make friends with it. Even though it never goes away, I educated myself, and I got into diving, and I practiced techniques that would save my life. To give you an example, there's what they call a free ascent. Let's say you have equipment failure at depth. And I had one happen one time at 80 feet. Your regulator stopped working. Well, what the hell do you do? Well, you've got a buddy down there. You can let him know, and he'll help you and do some buddy breathing together. Or you can go to the surface. But what you can't do is you can't panic, because as soon as you panic, you're going to drown. You're going to die. So I took classes that taught me how to do what they call a free ascent. And that is, let's say you're at any depth. When your regulator ceases to work, you have to make it to the surface. But you have to be very careful, because when you're at depth, the air that's in your lungs is under an extreme amount of pressure. And as you come up, that pressure is going to release, and that air is going to expand, and it's going to expand even if you don't have but just a shallow amount of air in your lungs. At 80 feet, by the time you get to the surface, you're going to have more air in your lungs than you need. And if you hold it in, your lungs are going to expand, and you're going to have an embolism. So what you have to do is you have to bleed off the air as you're coming up. So as the air expands, you bleed it off. Now remember, you're also somewhat fighting that urge to want to breathe. But you practice this. You get down there at 100 feet, and you take a breath of air, and you exhale completely, and then you start your ascent, and you keep your throat open, and as the air expands, you let the air out, and as you're coming up, your air fills with lungs, and all of a sudden, you've got more air than you need, and when you hit the surface, you're actually exhaling, and you're able to come from a situation which could die from, and you end up coming to the surface with no problem at all. In the case that what happened to me one time, the valve on my tank, when we were taking the boat out, the tanks were laying there with the regulators on them, and the boat was bouncing, and apparently it turned the air almost off, not all the way. But when I got down at 80 feet, the tank pressure dropped to a certain point. I couldn't get any air out of it. Well, I had no idea. All I had to do was reach up and open the valve, and I'd been fine. But I made this decision to make a free ascent, and it saved my life. And because I was able to think that through, because I had the training, panic didn't set in. And if panic would have set in, I could have died. There was many divers who tried to help a friend who had a problem with their regulator. Maybe they quit, and they give the person the air, and they're in a panic. You want to give him the air. He takes a breath, and you get back, and you take a breath, and then you slowly come up, and everybody's happy. But sometimes people just panic. They take the air, and they won't give it back to you, so they end up killing the person who tried to help them. Ignorant people, when you're ignorant, ignorant people have no power at all. Once you understand how our system of government works, you will know what you need to do. When you're absolutely sure that you're doing the right things, things change. A fearful, ignorant population cannot change anything. How can you change anything if you haven't the clue what the problem is? Maybe you're the problem. Now, if you're listening to fake stream media, you have no idea what's going on. Your mind is being poisoned by anti-American extremist propaganda. What about the polls? Polls are designed for one reason only, to control your opinion. They guide you. They play you like a harp from hell. The only way to free your mind is to break away from the false left-right paradigm. There is no difference between a Democrat or a Republican. Let that belief go. Let it go. It's destroying you. It's destroying the Republic. You cannot come out of ignorance with more ignorance. You can't change things by voting for the lesser of two evils. It's insanity. Now, I was with the InfoWars and their latest poll. They did the same thing. They had a poll. Do you agree with the president's bombing Syria? Do you disagree with the president bombing Syria? And then they had a third choice. I don't know. They never asked if scump, broke the law. Now, this is controlling the narrative, just like the corporate-controlled lamestream media does. It's not right, and it has to stop. Now, Alex Jones, and I made a video here. I really love him, and I do. I still love him. He's a great guy. He, like I said, he's a force of nature. But he has got himself in a situation here, supporting a politician. He believes so much that this guy is going to do the right thing that he's got blinders on now. I don't know what happened. And I do have a message for you, Alex, and I love you. I would like to see you wake up. And my message to Alex is when you play with shit, sooner or later you're going to get some on you. So I'm asking you, Alex, if you ever hear this, please return to a constitutional format. That's when you were doing your best. Let this scump go. He's part of the Demo Republic Nazi Party, and he is not going to do anything to change anything. He's one of them. Wake up. He pulled the wool over all of our eyes. And personally, I really don't care, because I can't stand either party. And like I said before, the only thing I did is I figured, well, you know, what I got to lose? You know, we're always going to be left with, at this point, with the choice of a Democrat or a Republican. Nobody's going to get off their ass and do a third party. We need to drive the Democrats and the Republicans. We need to drive those parties completely out of business. And what's sad is I used to be one of Alex's biggest fans. I mean, I went back. I can remember when he started. I've been with him since he started. I don't even turn him on anymore because it's just business as usual. I can hear the same type of rhetoric on the lamestream media. Don't cover for this guy. Isn't worth it. Now, for me, I know what is expected from each branch of government. I know how our constitutional republic works, or supposed to work. And I don't need a lawyer to tell me what the law is. We can all educate ourselves. You can go to the law library. They're very easy to search out a subject matter. It's all set up for you. You can find many of the court cases that I even talk about online. There are almost all of them on there. Every time I type them in, I'm surprised I can find the court case that I'm looking for. And unless if I want to find out how current it is and whether it's been overturned, overruled, or whatever, I can still take that and go to the law library, and we do what you call shepherdizing and check Shepard's citations and find out what the status of the case is. I mean, you have to do that if you're going to present a case in court. You got to make sure that it's still current and that it's still valid. Now, the best way to study our history, believe it or not, is to read Supreme Court cases. These cases reflect what is going on or what was going on at the time that they were written. These cases give you an insight on our nation's history. I'd like you to check out what I've been teaching. I think you'd be surprised because I do my research. The truth, it's out there. And when you find it, it will make you free. The Demo-Republic Nazis only have the power that we give them. It's time to take your power back. Take the red pill. Open your mind to the truth. If you're not part of the solution, then you are the problem. If you're politically correct, then you're legally wrong. I am the Ghettoman. Thank you for watching.
Ladies and gentlemen of Spaceship Earth, we have broken free of Earth's gravity, so you can now unbuckle your seatbelts and relax. You've all worked hard for this day. You are the righteous. Freedom is now yours. No more will you have to suffer the tyranny that's been imposed upon you in the land of the free and the home of the slave. Where wrong is right and right is wrong, where you are guilty until proven innocent. No more will your children have to die for oil profits and paper money. No longer will they be under the influence of the evil leaders of planet Earth. You are free from the beast and its lies. No longer can it deceive you. Corruption is no longer in you. safely in your hand, guarded jealously. Its seeds will feed you. It will also provide you with a rich oil to be used to fuel Spaceship Earth for your long journey. Its strong fiber will give you cloth. It'll give you rope and canvas to clothe you and to keep you warm. Its herd will give you paper. Paper for your books. Paper for your journals. Its flowers will provide a medicine to heal your people, both in body and in mind. Use its paper to amalgamate your consciousness with the consciousness of the endless universe. One day, you will return to planet Earth with a sword in your hand. You will purge the planet of all corruption and set the inhabitants free. Remember, people, you are eternal. You have already been here forever. You are light without end, omnipresent. Together, you are the conscious universe. You have eyes to see and ears to hear. You're beyond insanity.